Because I even know for a fact that we want to see. There's no way that we will see a new Gears. No way. I don't know, you know, because it's like with 5. We've literally just recently just released Operation 4. So it's like, there is still characters on the game that aren't even on the game yet. Unless if they do bring them out through store. And plus with the whole that Gears Tactics coming out as well. That literally recently came out. So them making a number 6, it would just seem a bit like wrong in a way, because they literally just gave support, more support to 5. And it's like, right, here's number 6. And plus, I do reckon it would be a lot better if it is the next gen only game, not the new gen. I mean, old gen as well. Because just imagine what it could. Just imagine what it would look like. The way it will play, like the more detailed stuff that they could put into the game. And a lot of people are wanting fucking Battle Royal for it. No, for Gears. A lot of people are talking about it. To me, it just wouldn't fit it. It really wouldn't. Because it's just too slow paced in a weird way. Well, it's too tactical. And plus, obviously, if it be in third person. So I say the only way they would make it work in a way is if they make it so like you actually bring the detail of destructible objects and shit. So you have, obviously you can force people to push in a way, since that's how the game is. So if I've got a torp bow and I'm thinking, right, I can't exactly get them, but I can just shoot the cover that they're on to obviously to destroy it. So they make some push or whatever. But I still say the one thing that they need to do, they need to change Horde. They desperately need to change it. Give it another reason for people to play it. Give it the reason for the people to think, oh mate, a new Horde, new gears, hard horde on it this time, it's gonna be sick, and it's like, it's just like with zombies in a way. Yeah, that's what I've always said. If it could make it a perfect mode with the whole classes and stuff. And it's like the whole atmosphere of the game is just perfect. Going through the campaign, destroying eggs, blowing up facilities and stuff, and it's like it could just make that extinct, like that horde. You could make it horde. You come in on a chopper, just like Extinction, and this is right, you need to destroy everything, you need to destroy the swarm within this area. And then meet us back here at this point, or whatever. And then you've got a certain time limit to do it all. Or you've just not, haven't got a time limit, and then when you get to the last bit, you place the bomb. And it's like, right, the swarm are coming, so you need to get back here now, or you're going to basically get left, or you're going to die. And then they could bring the whole horde element into the game, of making it so when you like destroying an egg or something, your swarm reacts as they do like on campaign, and then they start coming to you, and then that's when you start building shit. You can build walls, you can build turrets and stuff. So then it's like, oh, we've got a scout, right, quickly go out there and find some materials for us pretty quick, so then we can just build some. Got the medic, right, let me just place down a thing that basically heal us all and stuff. Got a soldier that mainly takes the bullets so everyone else can shoot back at them type shit. We've got the perfect opportunity to do it. Oh yeah. State of Decay 3 is going to be good. Yep. No, come on. Yeah. That Warhammer game is an instant buy. I mean, I'm definitely getting that. It's like I said, when I saw it, it gave a big Left 4 Dead feel to it. Yeah, but it would just be like that other Warhammer game, that with them, yeah. I even like the whole trailer that they've shown. The guy that's fucked up. You always get it in Left 4 Dead type games. The guy that's fucked up, the guy that knows what he's doing, the guy who's shitting himself, and then the other dude that's just like all around him. And then literally that guy with his torch on his light, on his gun, trying to make it work, and then that dude just taps it. Like, he's the one that's confident, he knows what he's doing. And then literally that earthquake was, they look in front of him and there's just millions of zombies in front of him. I'm thinking, yeah, that's definitely a buy. Yeah. Because that's a re. To be fair, I reckon that's actually a remake. That's a remake. Unless if it's actually going to carry on, because that game Stalker, it came out years ago, and I mean years ago. Slash Daisy. To be fair, I do give the conference about, let's say, about 5 out of 10. I give the conference event about 5 out of 10. And plus, to be fair, I am being biased a little bit because there wasn't really a game that like, I really wanted, obviously, to get announced, and obviously, it would. Killer Instinct 2. Because I was literally, because it said Rare, and I thought, mate, here we go. Rare's on it. Rare's going to be showing somewhere. But then they showed that cartoony fucking game. Obviously, right at the end, the dude says, take a look at this, and I'm thinking, please, please, Killer Instinct, please. And as soon as I seen the top of the sword, I said, it's Fable. 100% it's Fable. Yeah, because it's like even with the new Halo as well, it does give off a big, 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 big Halo 1 feel. I don't know what to do though. I've got work in, well, I've obviously got work in the morning, but there's a big, like, well, they're calling it a round table for the FGC. All the companies within, pretty much the proper companies within the FGC, they're getting together and they're going to be discussing shit. Since there hasn't really been anything relatable to fighting games for a long time. And I don't know if to stay up and watch it. fuck did he just do 2k damage on me from one hit? Woo. Plus 8. Just remember who the boss is for this mission. What's that fucking Ash dude? Holy shit. Even new stats. High attack damage. Increases damage on high stance attacks. Wait. I forgot, how do you make it so it triggers the animation again? I can't remember. So that's a mimic. It pops his head up sometimes.
Whoa.
Another mimic. great when the game screws you over, isn't it? Awesome feeling. You're literally halfway through an attack. It's got no stamina, but yet it still hits you. That's what should happen. Back and loop. It's also great when you get hit by a cannon and it doesn't affect you. That's another good one. You literally get full on hit by a cannon and it doesn't stun you. Thank you. mate, it was actually a good job that he did that. I would have died. Again. Ah, I finally put my sword back on. Just...